I'm Circe Nestroza, and I'm the exhibition curator of Appearances Can Be Deceiving, Frida Kahlo's Wardrobe. This exhibition actually explains how she builds her identity through two very important strands, which are disability and ethnicity. Most of the experts say that Frida Kahlo wore this dress to please Diego Rivera. So while I don't deny that, because I mean they were sort of inspiration, you know, I mean for each other, I think there are more intrinsic reasons, and the reasoning behind her choice of dress goes beyond that. You know, in the 30s or the 40s, when the fashion was really to look at Europe or Hollywood, or you know, it's the time when Maria Felix and all these Hollywood divas had the eyebrow up, the eyebrows, and when she had a monobrow kind of thing, you know, and then she chose to wear an ethnic dress that comes from the Tehuantepec Isthmus, which is a society that is managed by women. So this dress symbolizes a powerful woman. As people will be able to see, the exhibition is really small. It's quite small because we only have 5 rooms to show Kahlo's personal belongings and to explain all, you know, how she will lay her identity through disability and ethnicity, and then the contemporary pieces. So you have to do all of that and do, you know, compress the narrative in 5 rooms. So we will rotate the dresses. In Gallery 2, her looks, they will change every 5 months, also for conservation purposes, because the dresses can't be displayed for so long. Frida has left long-lasting impressions in our mind through her artworks, but also through her persona. It's been a fantastic journey, because really working with the archive has meant to go, you know, we've gone through her medicines, which was a really difficult day, because you know people were literally getting out of the room because they couldn't bear it. Or when we were doing dresses, you know, it brings a joy and happiness. So you can see how she was as well through these objects, because they do inform. They give you a lot of information about the person, and some of them do smell, and some of them do, you feel, you know, like the essence. And so yeah, it's been really almost surreal, really, like the experience of working with this archive has been absolutely out of the extraordinary.